Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. We're gonna be doing a first impressions video. This is my first impressions video. And today we're gonna be using the Amreezy Anastasia Beverly Hills palette. So yesterday I went to Ulta with the intentions on buying two new palettes. I was gonna go buy a Juvia's Place palette and Jackie Aina palette. However, when I went there, they didn't have it anymore. So, latest palette that they did have was the Amreezy palette. So, before buying the palette, I kind of knew who Amreezy was, or Amreezy. I kind of already knew who she was via social media, via Twitter, via Instagram, but I didn't know she was a makeup artist. I always thought she was one of those, like, Insta-famous girls, you know, like, I take pretty nice pictures, I look good, those type of girls. I never knew she was a makeup artist. So the Ulta that I went to, the palette was $49 plus tax. Now I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I did do a couple swatches. This is actually gonna be my very first time seeing it on my eyes. First of all, let's talk about the packaging. It's pink, it's glittery, it's girly, I love it. Let me just put this out there as a PSA. These types of cases, they're cute for the eyes. However, once you actually start to play with it and use it, so much glitter falling off of it. I don't even know how to describe it. Like, it's just like the glitter kind of like flakes off of it, which is annoying as crap because it's glitter everywhere. That's my only con. Everything else is pretty nice. I like it. You can actually do a lot with this palette. You can do, you know, your soft glam, natural glam looks, all the way up to a cut crease. I think these are some pretty cool colors to work with. I'm gonna go ahead and we're gonna get into this palette and see what Miss Amreezy is all about. First, we're gonna go into, the first color I'm gonna go into is OG. We're just applying some setting powder underneath the eyes because I do expect a ton of fallout. We're just taking Miss OG and we're just going right into the crease area with this color. And we're just gonna blend her out. Like to go right here in this little area right here, and I just like to blend the transition color into my eyebrow. It looks so much nicer. I would take makeup pictures and there would literally be a space between the eyeshadow, the concealer, and the eyebrow. And then next I'm gonna take 1988 and we're gonna place her right here at the outer V of the eye, and we are going to blend her out. Okay, Miss 1988, I see you, sus. I see you blending out all nicely. I like that. Okay, so the first two colors, they look good. I wasn't expecting them to look this good, but then again, it is Anastasia. I've never tried the ABH palette before, but let me tell you something. These colors, I like them. I'm really liking the blendation of the situation. The crease is cut through money ching. Running around with the goons in the car with big guns that'll send you to God. I recommend that you have like a mirror and you look down at the mirror. It always works for me. It helps me see the dimension of my eyeball instead of trying to look forward. When you look down, you can see it a lot better. I hope it makes sense. I'm just patting out the concealer so it's not as wet as it once was. I think I'm gonna go into New Yorker a little bit, only a little bit, to blend this up into the eyebrow, and we're blending that right on top of the cut crease. We cut the crease, but the thing is, I like a cut, not cut crease. Technically, it would be called a reverse cut crease. I found that out recently. So for the lid color, we're actually gonna take Barb. I swatched Barb and I actually love her. Oh, this is a pretty color. I'm not gonna lie, this is such a pretty color. I was kind of weary at first about the whole glitter situation, only because in palettes, glitter isn't really something that I go for. Palettes with glitter in them usually are not the best. We're gonna put her right over top of the cut crease. Well, where we cut the crease. Oh, yes. Ooh. Okay, bitch. Okay, so Miss Barb, Barbara, Mrs. Shirley, Barb plays no games. Oh my God. Oh my God.
Wow! Oh my God!
Now, she's looking kind of like spacey, and we want to make sure we marry the colors together. So, I'm thinking about taking Sesma. I think that's how you pronounce it. If it's not, oh well. And we are going to place her where we put the first color at. And we're just putting her in the outer V because we want to add dimension to this look.
Let's play a little game just between you and I.
These colors, they're pretty. Barb looks pink, but once you put her on the eyes, she looks like she has green reflex in it. And I'm here for it. I like it. I like that. Today I'm using the Kiss Pull Up Collection in Corset. I'm gonna take Sesma, I'm gonna put her on the bottom of my lashes as well. It is not no damn Sesma. It is Sesma. I actually don't know what it is because of that little accent mark. But what else? We're gonna take Sesma and we're gonna put her in the bottom lash. I'm now taking this Coastal Scents blush palette. I'm taking the pink shade on the very bottom row and I'm just gonna apply that to the apples of my cheeks. I love this Real Techniques brush because it hugs the cheekbone. So you guys should already know what I'm reaching for next. I'm going for my Billy Boutique palette and I will be using one of the shimmers as a highlight once again. A little goes a long way. So I'm trying this new thing where I'm actually putting the highlighter on the apples of my cheeks because normally I would just put it on the hollows of my cheeks, but now I kind of like putting it on the apples of my cheeks. See, look at that. Last but not least, we are going to do the lips, honey. To add with the whole theme of the purples and the pinks, I'm gonna take my Nika K lip liner in Plum and line my lips. So for the lips today, I'm using my NYX Matte Lipstick and Butter. And at the very last second, I did decide to go in with Nika K Lip Shine Lip Gloss, and this is in Taupe. And I just put that in the very center of my lips. This is the finished look. I really like the palette. I really liked Barb. Ball by herself, she is just one of a kind. I'll probably be doing a few other looks using the AmRezzy palette. I really liked it. I really like the colors. I like the color scheme and I like the glitters as well. The glitters literally just glide on. They adhere to the eyelids super easy. It's not messy. It has nice transition shades or shades that you can use all by themselves. If you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Drop a comment down below or subscribe to this channel because, I mean, you made it to the very end. You like this. So you might as well just, you know, watch my other videos as well. And if you're not already, please subscribe to my channel and I will see you guys in the next one.